Today is Monday, September the 30th, 2024. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how I trade a system that I call buy low, buy high on the SPX, the index for the S&P 500. As the title of the strategy suggests, this is about buying options. It's not about selling options. So keep that in mind. Also, any times that you see shown on my screen are in the central US time zone because that's where I live. Basically, this is a very simple strategy. The buy low in the name of the strategy means we're going to buy a call option when the SPX index falls below the current low of day. And we're going to buy a put option when the SPX rises above the current high of day. Once we're in the position, we try to get out as quickly as possible for a $1 profit. And as far as the risk management is concerned, if the position falls by $5 in value, then we're going to exit the position and accept the loss on that position. Now, one thing I've been thinking about is what I possibly could do in the event that a position clearly is in trouble. Maybe it's down, say, $3, but somehow it's able to recover and come back to break even. I'm going to experiment with potentially closing out that position and just accepting basically no gain and no loss on that position, a break even trade in that circumstance. All right, that's pretty much it. So how do I track this? This is my TastyTrade account. I don't need to use any kinds of charts because TastyTrade platform lets you set up this left-hand side here to where you could see the current low of day and the current high of day. You can configure this. It wasn't on here by default, but I added it as something that I wanted to see. And then, of course, the value, the current value of the instrument is shown here. So this means that just these three pieces of information, the current low of day, the current high of day, and the current value of the index is all that I need in order to trade this. Now, the low of day and the high of day is not populated right now, and that's because the market is closed. But after the market has been open for 15 minutes, I wait until that point because a low of day has been established and a high of day has been established by 15 minutes after the market opened, and there's some kind of range there. And so at that point, I can just start monitoring this value here, this value, and then the current value. So that means I'm not using a chart, I'm not using an indicator, I'm not using anything other than these three pieces of information. All right, so the next step here is going to be to wait until the market's been open for 15 minutes. And then at that point, I can start putting trades on when I see a breach of the low or a breach of the high. I should probably mention too that my balance here is $181,332. So the idea of taking a $5 loss on any given position needs to be considered in the context of how much cash I have. Typically, I'm trading five contracts. So five contracts on SPX represents a position where if I were to lose that $5 after having buying the contract, it would mean my account would be down $2,500. So I think that when I get the cash in the account up to 200,000, I can switch or double the contracts up to 10. And that would mean that the maximum loss that I could take on any one position would be $5,000. But again, that $5,000 loss, you have to consider that in the context of having an account that's $200,000. So I think taking a risk on any one position of approximately 2.5% is reasonable. just thinking too about which contract I'm trading. So I'm in the zero DTE, so I'll only be looking at SPX contracts that will expire today, not tomorrow or any other day, just expiring today. Let me think, what other frequently asked questions are there? Oh, win rate. Someone asked me about what's the win, you know, multiple people have asked me, what's the win rate? I don't really know what the win rate is. How I've been tracking my performance is just looking at P&L. I placed my first SPX trade on July the 11th, 2024. And prior to trading SPX, I opened this account in June of 2024. I started trading some ordinary stock options, a little bit of options in crude oil. I've gained some dividends in the account as well as a result of those stock options. I was doing cover calls and puts, naked puts. But the vast majority of this P&L is due to trading SPX. So I might start tracking the win rate, although I'm thoroughly convinced that P&L is all that matters. Like, really, does anything else matter except for P&L? I don't think so. But anyhow, I might start tracking the win rate. Just a little bit of extra accounting or record keeping, but I'll consider doing that. Okay, low established at 24 and 37. Looking for a breach of either of those. Looking for a breach of 2467. Filled at 12:10. Looking to get out at 13:10. New low at 24:35. Looking for a possible break of the high of the day, 57.37 and a half. So dancing up here around the high of day, just waiting for it to exceed it. And we're on the put side. Rule says buy a put on a breach of the high. I just repositioned to the 57.40 because if we do get a breach of 57.37.50, the index will be closer to 57.40 than it would be to 57.35. There is a breach. Filled at 10:30, looking to get out at 11:30.
high 38.45. New high at 38.87. New high here at 39.47. right, so index here seems to be in no man's land between the current low of day and high of day. I think that's a wrap for today.